Something went wrong with my original video, so I have to do two parts. So this is part two of my making a pine frame. I'll be taking off as little as possible, so if I make mistakes on the other side, I have room to correct. Well, instead of using a stop block, I put the top board right on top, the good cut board, right on top of my other one that I want to cut. Make sure the ends are perfectly aligned. Stop blocks, I'm sure, would be a lot better way to do it. But this is how I do it. One thing I didn't mention before, and I want to make sure to point this out, is before you do any of the precise cutting of the miter edges, make sure you sand all pieces. It will make it a lot easier later on when you're putting it together if everything is already sanded and ready to go there. So here are my four pieces. There's my works of art I have. Checking for fitting. I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to zoom in and let you take a look a little bit closer. I am very excited to be using my new router and router table. I'm going to be using as a test piece, always a test piece to make sure it works correctly. I'm going to set the width a quarter of an inch. So my picture will fit into the frame both on the sides and top and bottom. And then I'm going to have the thickness of it in the back half an inch. However, I don't want to do the whole half an inch in one pass because it's too much really for the router bit to handle. I'm going to be doing it in quarter inch and then quarter inch so that it won't chew up my lovely frame that I ended up just cutting. So here we go. I have decided to use a larger test piece. The other pieces were just way too small, about 5 inches long. So when you are routing, make sure that you have the piece firmly against your fence and be looking at that instead of watching the board go through, because you want to make sure you're always keeping it against the fence. Have a nice, slow, steady pace all the way through. I have finished all four, half an inch deep, quarter of an inch width. And I wanted to point out that I have all sorts of push sticks. Always use push sticks when you have especially narrow boards like this to work with. Anytime that your fingers can be close to the blade, be safe. I have all the frame pieces together upside down to make sure that it fits properly for what I'm going to put inside of it. I realized I did not cut it a half an inch deep, but everything seems to fit in real well. So I'm not going to take it back and cut it deeper because when I put everything in, it's actually flat with the frame on the back. So I'm real happy with that. I bought this frame clamp for $23 and it has been so helpful. I built quite a few frames before I had this and it's such a hassle. And this makes life so much easier. I've taken the frame out of the clamps. I'm sanding it thoroughly. Then I'm going to be wiping off any of the extra sawdust so that I can do my staining. Now I'm gluing up the inside of my frame. I'm going to glue my art piece directly to the frame because I won't be using this frame for anything else. Here I am with my finished project. I stained my pine frame to match the background of my griffin, and I think it turned out pretty nice. I hope you've learned something from this video, and I hope you give it a try someday. If you like what you see, please click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much.